Hello children, welcome back to our science session. In this session we will start our new chapter, chapter 9, reproduction in animals. If you see, there are various different types of, or you can tell different varieties of organisms around us. Organisms includes both plants and animals. If we see, varieties of plants and animals are there in our environment. This is what we call that as variation. So why this variation is essential? What are the importance of variation? Variation is important for the survival of species, as it allows some individuals to withstand and changes in the environment, or we can call that as niches. And how this variation is brought about, how in our environment, how do varieties of organisms exist, which brings these variations among organisms. If you see, let's recall, there are different types of different life processes are there in organisms, isn't it? If you see different process, if I ask you name some life processes, you can name it as digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, and so on. And these processes are essential for the survival of individual. And we have also learnt about the process of reproduction in plants, isn't it? Reproduction is also essential for the continuation of species. And imagine what would happen if organisms had not reproduced. We will realize that reproduction is important as it ensures the continuation of similar kinds of individuals generation after generation. So several processes like circulation of blood, respiration, excretion, etc., all these processes are essential for survival of human beings as well as other animals. Similarly, reproduction is also essential to maintain the continuity of in the species. If reproduction in animals, or if reproduction in organisms, if it doesn't take place, no similar kind of organisms will be present on the earth generation after generation. So in order to maintain the continuity of different species on the earth, what is essential? Reproduction is essential. And as we have learned reproduction in plants in our previous classes, this chapter we shall learn how reproduction takes place in animals. So in this chapter we are going to learn about how reproduction takes place in animals. If you see, like in plants, there are two modes of reproduction, isn't it? The same way in animals also, animals reproduce by two methods or two modes of reproduction, namely sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. And if you see, what are the similarities between reproduction in plants and animals? Plants and animals, as we know, they can both undergo sexual as well as asexual and asexual process of reproduction. Just like plants, in animals, the males and females have different reproductive organs. In plants, we know that in a flower is a reproductive part of a plant which consists of both male part as well as female part, isn't it? The same way in animals, here if you see, male organisms and female animal organism is different. They have male reproductive part and reproductive organs, and females have female reproductive organs. And then if you see in both plants and animals, zygote is formed when the male and female gametes fuse together, and hence zygote develops into new individuals. Thus, in this chapter, we will be learning about modes of reproduction in animals, that is asexual reproduction, which includes budding and binary fission. And then we are going to learn about sexual reproduction in animals, which includes male reproductive part in human and as well as female reproductive part in human beings. Then we will be learning about fertilization, types of fertilization like external fertilization, internal fertilization. Then we will be learning about development of embryo, and then finally how young one develops into adult. So children, these are all the topics we are going to cover in this chapter. And so let's start. What is reproduction? If you see, reproduction is a process by which the organisms produce or generate new individual of the same kind. As we have learned, reproduction generally, if you take in plants and animals, reproduction is classified into two types: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. And first, let's have asexual reproduction. Generally, if you see, what is asexual reproduction? It is a process of formation of new individual from any specialized or unspecialized part of single parent without fertilization. Asexual reproduction involves only a single parent by a specialized or unspecialized part. And if you see, asexual reproduction is classified into six types, namely fission, fragmentation, regeneration, budding, vegetative propagation, and spore formation. These types includes both in animals, and some type A of asexual reproduction occur in plants. And if you see, first type, fission, it is a type of asexual reproduction in which parent cell, it splits into two or more daughter cells. So this division can take place in any plane, any type, longitudinal or horizontal plane. Example, we are going to learn about this in animal cell, that is amoeba. Amoeba binary fission takes place. This we will be learning in detail manner. Then what is fragmentation? That is, this we have learned, it is a type of asexual reproduction in which the parent cell is simply break into smaller pieces after maturation, fragments, pieces. So this method is called as fragmentation. It occurs in plants, example Spirogyra. Then regeneration, here it is a type of asexual reproduction in which parent cell cut or break into several pieces, and each and every piece will develop into new individual, example Planaria. And then budding, it is a type of reproduction. Here it develops into after the outgrowth will occur due to repeated cell division, and this at one specific site the bud will develop, and then it develops into a new individual. When it is fully mature, then it detaches from the parent body. And this example Hydra. And we have learned already budding in yeast, isn't it, in your seventh standard. So here it is, as reproduction in animals, we are going to learn about budding in Hydra in detailed manner. Then about next type of asexual reproduction is vegetative propagation. It is a type of asexual reproduction in which plant parts like roots, stem, leaves and all, it develops into new plants. Here in this picture, you have learned vegetative part, that is leaf, how it develops into a new plant. Example Bryophyllum. This also we have learned in 7th standard. Then spore formation, It is a type of asexual reproduction in which the spores in the sporangium, when it bursts, when it comes out, after matured, each and every spore will develop into new individual. Example, mucor, or you can tell rhizophus. And among all these type of asexual reproduction, this chapter we are going to learn only about asexual reproduction in animals, that is binary fission and budding in detailed manner. And so children, what is the importance of reproduction in organisms? Reproduction is a vital phenomenon on this planet Earth. It is essential for existence and continuity of life and species generation after generation. And if you see, what is the difference between sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction in animals? Now here, this chapter, we are going to learn only in animals. So what is the difference between sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction in animals? Sexual reproduction, a reproduction which takes place by the fusion of male and female gametes. And asexual reproduction is a reproduction in which only a single parent is involved. And sexual reproduction, it takes place in animals like humans, cow, etc. And asexual reproduction takes place in hydra and amoeba. And thus, asexual reproduction in animals, it involves only a single parent. It takes place in microscopic animals like amoeba and small animals like hydra. Okay, children, and we will stop the session here. And in next session, we are going to learn in detail about asexual reproduction, how it takes place in amoeba and hydra in a detailed manner. That's all for this session. Thank you.